Education must continue. With the strong leadership of Secretary Leonor M. Briones, the Department of Education is determined and committed to fulfill its mandate to the school children entrusted to us amidst pandemic. Indeed, the issuance of DepEd Order Number 007 Series 2020, School Calendar and Activities for School Year 2020-2021, and Basic Education Learning Continuity Plan translate the commitment of the Department of Education to ensure educational continuity despite the crisis, but the health and safety of our learners and the whole school communities are of utmost importance and must be protected at all times. It is in this light that the Department of Education, Misamis Occidental, conceptualizes a realistic, attainable, and flexible learning continuity plan anchored on the principles of accessible, equitable, relevant, liberating, and quality education for all Misamis learners in the context of COVID. The division's learning continuity plan is the recourse to ensure that education for all Misamis learners is sustained without compromising everyone's health and safety. The collaborative effort of the different functional divisions, units, and sections of the division, particularly the Curriculum and Implementation Division and the School Governance and Operations Division. Consultations and surveys with partners, stakeholders, teachers, parents, and even among learners were conducted, ensuring the best service from across the strata in the division's level of governance could be provided to the DepEd Misamis Occidental has conducted a number of consultations, internal discussions, and data gathering in the development of the plan to ensure contextualized and relevant strategies adapted to the context of the province. Various considerations are highlighted, especially on the learning needs of the learners, observance to health and safety protocols, conditions of the parents, availability of resources, context of the community, capacity of teachers to deliver new normal teaching modalities, and school leaders' competence to provide technical assistance to guarantee a responsive, realistic, attainable, and compassionate plan. The Learning Continuity Plan outlines the strategies, interventions, and innovations of the division in both school management and operations and curriculum delivery geared towards learning continuity despite the pandemic situation. This plan is developed para sa bata, para sa bata. The data and figures that are presented in this learning continuity plan are substantial in determining the allocations of resources, especially in teachers' deployment, item allocations, maintenance and other operating expenses, and other miscellaneous expenses to ensure that there would be no disparities in the distributions of resources and that there is equitable delivery of basic education services. Moreover, it also proposes intensified safety measures and mandatory observance of public health standards, especially among all schools, seeing to it that they are compliant to maximum health protocols. Calendar of activities are also lined up, providing for the curricular and co-curricular activities that are allowable in this new normal. Strategies and approaches as to how this will be done without compromising academics are still considered in the planning process. Proper monitoring and evaluation will be conducted to ensure efficient implementation of all programs. As the learning modalities and strategies, the division opts only to employ blended distance learning strategies and alternative delivery module for the alternative learning system learners, knowing that these are the most common response made by parents during the consultation period. The division is, in fact, initiates concise self-instructional materials in addition to what have been provided by the central office and the regional office to guarantee that children can still benefit optimum learning even without their parents helping them. The Curriculum and Implementation Division significantly focuses its endeavors on the major adjustments that are to be urgently implemented in the area of selecting learning strategies and modalities appropriate to the learning levels of learners while taking account the present conditions and available resources of the locality. The division was able to give more focus to the learning activities and resources while having sufficient time for coverage and mastery, believing that a decongested curriculum answers the need for more focus on the adjustments to be made in the learning delivery. The development of learning resources is in the place to sufficiently and effectively cover the most efficient learning competencies, its content and performance standards, and at the same time, observing contextualization and localization for learning to be of quality and relevance despite and amidst the pandemic. Our learning delivery options include distance learning. This modality does not allow face-to-face interaction of teacher and learner. They are remote from each other but interacts through a mechanism depending on the selected format, which are as follows: modular distance learning and online distance learning. Radio-based instruction. Blended distance learning, in which this modality could mean a combination of face-to-face and any or all of the distance learning modalities. But if face-to-face is still not possible, it could be a combination of any or all of the distance learning modalities. Alternative delivery mode. This is a modality long been implemented by the alternative learning system, which shall still be continued, replacing face-to-face with learning facilitators with any of the distance learning modalities or blended learning. The provision and preparation of learning resources responsive to the varied learning modalities are significant steps to ensure that learning continue despite the pandemic times. These learning resources are learners' learning partners in learning and are bridge of the teachers to communicate learning competencies and achieve mastery despite the distance learning.
Quarantine PISO is not only an acronym but more of a battle cry to remind everyone in the division of its primary mandate, which is to teach the learner in whatever modality appropriate to their context. The exclamatory mark specifies the urgency of its implementation to immediately respond to the need for quality and relevance in the delivery of instruction, integrating the protocols of the community in the implementation of COVID-19 precautions. The program brings all teachers back to the classroom, be it actual or virtual, more competent and confident through solid knowledge, skills, and attitudes of 21st century facilitator of learning, ably provided with the technical assistance from school heads and supervisors, while the rest of the school staff and division personnel deliver timely and efficient services to support their needs and aspirations as stalwarts of the battle against ignorance and mediocrity. The program strongly accounts engagement of and support from stakeholders in the delivery of different services to ensure that the whole school community gets all the possible help and assistance to reach its goal of making every learner achieve lifelong learning in a milieu free from fear and exposure to the much dreaded disease. Everyone then is tasked to move towards the same direction of providing a conducive environment for teaching and learning, henceforth ensuring learners to contribute meaningfully to building the nation more significantly in the most pressing moment of the present times. With Quarantine PISOC, KAIT will not only soar to its desired level of implementation, it will reach its height of accomplishment in whatever present classroom our learners are, where teachers expertly facilitate learning and constantly nurture every learner. Quarantine PISO stands for Quality and Relevance Amid the New Normal, Torn Paradigm, Enlist by All Possible Means, Acts Gained for Learners, Clear Up K-12 for Better Implementation, and Heal for Better Services.